Good evening. Congrats on all the wins associated with the artist.
Thank you so much.
And I wanted to ask you guys, I mean, there's been a proliferation of kind of supernatural-based shows lately. And first of all, maybe you could tell me what some favorites are of yours, and then how Grimm sets itself apart from them.
As far as TV shows?
As far as TV goes.
I mean, I watch Top Chef religiously. We love all the shows like True Blood and Grimm and Supernatural and all the fairy tale shows. And there's apparently been a pretty direct correlation between the state of the economy and an interest in mythology. And I think that makes a lot of sense. People are more interested. What?
No, it's true. I agree with you. A little escapism is good these days.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And so what do you guys think you're doing to set Grimm apart, to make people really take notice of the show?
One of the things that's different about Grimm from other shows is that everything takes place within one world. So there are all these monsters and stuff, and the idea is they're walking among us, and very few people can see them. The guy who plays my boyfriend on Grimm, this great actor, Dave Gentoli, he can see the monsters and the creatures. But it's interesting to imagine people walking among us who are actually monstrous. Not that hard to imagine, actually.
With the election coming up.
Yeah. Exactly.
Well, thank you so much, guys. Have a great time tonight.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.